We're going to look now at a bit of Dakota heritage, a time when corn was harvested by hand. These days, the hard work is a sport at the State Hand Corn Picking Championship.
1 ear at a time is how it's done in this low-tech, full manual approach to harvesting corn. Horses and wagons complete the scene and make it easy to picture the way things used to be done.
People used to do this for a living, and we're doing it just to have some fun and also for the competition to go on and compete.
The top three finishers in each bracket will go to the national contest in Kansas. Brackets are determined by age and depending on your bracket.
You will either be picking for 10, 20, or 30 minutes, and a gleaner and a judge will follow you. The judge or the timer is the one that keeps track of the time. The timer is the one also that if there's any problems with the horses, they will stop that clock so that you'll still have that time to make it up. The gleaner's job is basically to pick up whatever you have left. After your time limit, you are asked to come back to the weigh area, and that then is taken against you. And then it goes by your weight, and then that determines what placings you will have.
One thing about hand corn picking compared to some other sports, it doesn't require much special equipment.
I'm putting on what we call my husking hook. And this is what I wear on my hand to initially loosen the husk on the ear of corn, which I'm going to snap off and toss into the wagon. I get the ear of corn like that, and this hook is, the first job that hook does is open up that ear, see? And then I go right back and snap it out and flip it into the wagon. And that's the trick of the corn husking, is to snap them out quick, get rid of them, get on the next ear.
Few, if any, in the competition have as much experience as VanLiere.
I was a farm kid, and my dad took my brother and I out in the field when we were 5, 6, 7 years old, and that's when we learned to husk corn by hand. That was the only way corn was husked or harvested in those days. So it's something you had to learn to do. Corn husking season was this extra special work season. We got up, say, 4:30, 5 o'clock in the morning, milked cows by hand, and did a few other chores. And we learned to harness our big horses. So by that time, we'd have our horses hooked up in wagon. We'd be in the field around 7:30, 8 o'clock, and we'd husk corn all day long. And then we did chores again in the evening. It was a big day, and I still believe that young farm kids could do what they did. Corn husking contests were popular back then, and my brother and I, we both were interested in getting into those contests. But my dad had other ideas. He said, when you guys get grown up, when you're 18 or so, you can probably get into contests. He says, until then, you work at home.
But VanLiere finally did get into a contest, a lot of them as a matter of fact. He's won the national title several times, including the 50 and up championship in 2009. VanLiere's days of actually working at hand corn picking ended in the early 1940s when the first mechanical pickers came on the scene.
And of course nowadays you see these big combines come through a field. One day they'll pick as much as what we probably picked in our whole season.
The days of hand harvesting are gone, but for at least one fall afternoon in South Dakota, the sights and sounds linger on.